Political candidates have always had a very interesting way of addressing the idea of natural law and natural rights. But Hugo Grotius has all the answers. In his work regarding freedom of the seas, Hugo Grotius puts forth a revolutionary idea that all nations should have freedom of travel and trade on the high seas. Specifically, in the case of the Dutch, Grotius says they have a right to sail to the East Indies and a right to engage with trade with the people there, but he admits that this right extends to all nations. In his work, The Rights of War and Peace, Grotius lays the foundation for what would later become international law, providing guidance for how states should interact with other states, as well as ideas of just war, all of which affirm that many at different times and in different places affirm the same thing as certain, that ought to be referred to a universal cause. And this cause, in the lines of inquiry which we are following, must be either a correct conclusion drawn from the principles of nature or common consent. The former points to the law of nature, the latter to the law of nations. When discussing the rights of the magistrate, Beza presents a means for protecting citizens within a state from tyranny. He says that subjects can by some means, with no offense to God, check or if need be expel by armed force the evident tyranny of the supreme ruler. Such a statement lays the foundation for Hugo Grotius to create an international legal tradition to support citizens of any state when presented with the opposition of tyranny. In his written work regarding sovereignty, Jean Bodin put forth the idea that a prince answers to no higher power, as this would make him a subject. But Hugo Grotius believes that even a prince should answer to the higher power of jus gentium, otherwise known as the law of nations, specifically when such a prince deals with other states at an international level. Francisco de Vitoria believes that you cannot use religion as a means to dispossess people of their property. He still believes that religion has a place within the natural law, natural rights tradition, but this diverges from Grotius, as he believes that there is no God, or that the affairs of man are of no concern to him, within the confines of the tradition, of course. In every age, independent and wise and devout men have been able to root out false doctrine from the minds of the simple, and to convict its advocates of shamelessness, and Hugo Grotius is just the man for the job.